this. I really don't want to because I like to review everything I watch. No. I watched the season finale of Gravity Falls and it was good. Stuff happened. People cried.
Wait.
And there's a conspiracy theory about some stuff and some things, and one dude is related to another dude, and then some dudes happen, and then dude.
Kids! I can't believe it! I thought I lost you two!
So, in the season finale, we have the twins, and they're trying to defeat Bill, the evil triangle guy, because he's trying to, like, take over the world, but he can't break out of the bubble of Gravity Falls, because there's a, like, weird force field around it. In order to break that force field, he has to destroy the twins, and so there's this whole thing going around that. And then in the end, one big giant battle that goes on. They turn the Mystery Shack into a giant robot, everyone does the Care Bear Stare, and then, like, Stan refuses to hold his brother's hand, and so the Care Bear Stare kind of just, like, diminishes. Then Bill comes around, and he's like, well, fuck you guys, I'm gonna turn you all into flags. And so he turns everyone into flags, and starts chasing down Mabel and Dipper. And Stan and Stanley are like hopeless in this little jail, and they decide to switch clothes because Stanford has a plate in his head and Stanley doesn't. And so they switch clothes, pretend like they're one another. And so Bill goes inside one of the twins' heads and discovers that it is the wrong twin, and then gets erased. And then Stanley gets amnesia, and there's like tears, waterworks everywhere, and they try to help him get back his memory, and Bill is defeated. And they slowly gain back his memory, which is kind of good. But the whole time you're just crying. Town recognizes that Dipper and Mabel are like the two town heroes, yay!
Stanley Pines has fully recovered his memory and will be throwing a party to celebrate his niece and nephew's 13th birthday and final day in town.
And they declare a new law, which is...
Never mind all that!
And if you break the rules, we're gonna zap you.
Zap, zap! We're mad with power!
So, they end up going back to California, back home, because the summer ends and it's their 13th birthday. And they're about to leave Waddles and Gravity Falls, and Grunkle Stan is all like...
This pig is coming with the kids!
Now, hold on a second. Bringing animals aboard a moving vehicle is strictly prohibited by...
Everything so forth, but I have this conspiracy theory, yay! That, okay, so, you know how Grunkle Stan dropped a mug and a pen and a paper pad into the vortex in one of the episodes and it came out? Rick, This Way Comes, it goes into like another portal in that episode in Rick and Morty?
Alright, you're getting closer. Every day it's getting strong. Ah!
So there's this thing, which a lot of people on Tumblr already shipped them, which we don't know. Already had this idea that freaking A.
Grunkle Stan, Grunkle Ford, and Grandpa Rick are best buds.
Well, not really best, but like, they came across each other once or twice. The only reason why Grunkle Stan is there came back to this dimension is because Grandpa Rick was like too into like a bunch of illegal shit, and then Grunkle Ford was all like square and rule abiding. Yeah, that's why he didn't ever really come back to this dimension. Because Rick could totally come back to this dimension and totally like help throw out, but no, that's like the whole purpose of not breaking the rules.
You see, it's funny because marriage is terrible.